Military general reveals disgusting thing Obama did after his son was killed by Muslims, Trump was right. The mainstream media has been up in arms after President Donald Trump stated that Barack Obama did not call the families of fallen soldiers to inform them of their loss. Instead of these investigative journalists digging into these claims before flying off the handle, they immediately began to call Trump a liar, and as usual, the liberal media was proven wrong. Just recently, General John Kelly, a Marine general who commanded a multinational force in Iraq, stepped forward and revealed precisely what Barack Obama didn't do, proving that Trump was right yet again. Over the course of the last 8 years, Barack Obama has done everything in his power to show Americans his utter disdain for our country and its military heroes. If Obama was not cutting military funding, he was spitting in the face of our veterans by allowing terrible healthcare to continue at veteran medical facilities across the country while taking million-dollar vacations on the taxpayer's dime. Now, it has been revealed that Obama also showed his contempt for our military and their families by not personally notifying them when one of our heroes perished in action. One of those individuals that was not personally notified by Obama was General Kelly, whose son was killed in action while he was deployed in Afghanistan on November 9, 2010. The mainstream media has been up in arms after President Donald Trump stated that Barack Obama did not call the families of fallen soldiers to inform them of their loss. Instead of these investigative journalists digging into these claims before flying off the handle, they immediately began to call Trump a liar, and as usual, the liberal media was proven wrong. Just recently, General John Kelly, a Marine general who commanded a multinational force in Iraq, stepped forward and revealed precisely what Barack Obama didn't do, proving that Trump was right yet again. Over the course of the last 8 years, Barack Obama has done everything in his power to show Americans his utter disdain for our country and its military heroes. If Obama was not cutting military funding, he was spitting in the face of our veterans by allowing terrible healthcare to continue at veteran medical facilities across the country while taking million-dollar vacations on the taxpayer's dime. Now, it has been revealed that Obama also showed his contempt for our military and their families by not personally notifying them when one of our heroes perished in action. One of those individuals that was not personally notified by Obama was General Kelly, whose son was killed in action while he was deployed in Afghanistan on November 9, 2010. Marine First Lieutenant Robert Kelly was killed in action in Afghanistan in 2010. At the time of Kelly's son's death, he was the commander of the Marine Forces Reserve and Marine Forces North, and according to administration sources, Obama never picked up the phone to alert the family that their son had died in action. Here is more from ABC News. Adding to the continued drama over whether past presidents have called the families of fallen soldiers, a senior White House official told ABC News today that then-President Obama did not call John Kelly, now the White House chief of staff, after the death of his son in 2010. The retired general's son, First Lieutenant Robert Kelly, died in action while serving with the Marines in Afghanistan. Kelly and his wife attended a breakfast for Gold Star families at the White House in 2011 and sat at First Lady Michelle Obama's table, a person familiar with the breakfast told ABC News. But the breakfast, scheduled to be hosted by the Obamas, was 6 months after the death of Kelly's son. It's unclear whether President Obama contacted Kelly about his son in any way prior to this. President Obama's office did not respond today to a request for comment on whether he contacted Kelly in another way. The White House comment comes a day after President Donald Trump made the unsubstantiated statement that most past presidents, including Obama, did not make calls to the families of fallen soldiers. If you look at President Obama and other presidents, most of them didn't make calls, a lot of them didn't make calls. I like to call when it's appropriate, when I think I'm able to do it, Trump said at a news conference in the White House Rose Garden Monday. When asked about his comment that Obama didn't call the families of the fallen again later in the news conference, Trump said, "I don't know if he did. I was told that he didn't often. And a lot of presidents don't, they write letters. I do. President Obama, I think, probably did sometimes, and maybe sometimes he didn't. I don't know. That's what I was told. All I can do is ask my generals, he added. Other presidents did not call. They write letters. And some presidents didn't do anything. But I like the combination of, when I can, the combination of a call and also a letter. The question came up during the news conference in reference to the four U.S. soldiers killed in an ambush in Niger. A former Obama official said Trump's Monday Rose Garden statement, and not specifically addressing the claim about Kelly, was unequivocally wrong. President Obama engaged families of the fallen and wounded warriors throughout his presidency through calls, letters, visits to Section 60 at Arlington, visits to Walter Reed, visits to Dover, and regular meetings with Gold Star families at the White House and across the country, the former Obama official said in a statement to ABC News. Over the past 8 years, the American people witnessed Barack Obama's disgust with America and everything we stand for, and the fact that he did not call fallen soldiers' families personally just confirms everything we have said about him in the past. Obama not picking up the phone to personally inform our nation's heroes is beyond disgusting and utterly reprehensible. Thankfully, we finally have a commander-in-chief that does give a damn about our military and their families, and to be perfectly honest, it is way overdue.